now to the making of a new opera from a story set amid the horror of the Civil War. The second performance is tonight in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Jeffrey Brown was there for the premiere this weekend.
In the new opera Cold Mountain, we first meet W.P. Inman at a Confederate military hospital in Virginia, as he and other soldiers mourn the loss of yet another fallen comrade. Wounded and sick of war's horror, Inman decides he's had enough and walks away, a deserter, towards Ada Monroe. Woman he left behind in the Blue Ridge Mountains of Western North Carolina. The opera's composer is Jennifer Higdon.
I realized that I grew up so close to Cold Mountain that the people and the landscape, their speech patterns, the language, it felt like something that I knew well enough to be the subject of a first opera.
Really, it felt familiar as in these are my people or this is my land?
Yes, actually, yeah. And I thought to myself, well, there's a lot of love and death in this and those are big opera themes, so it seemed perfect.
Higdon was raised on the Tennessee side of those mountains. Her parents loved rock and roll. There was no classical music in her childhood.
No opera at all, unless you count Grand Ole Opry, but other than that.
Years later, Higdon is one of the most celebrated and performed composers in the country, with a Pulitzer Prize and a constant stream of commissions for orchestral and chamber music. But she'd never tried her hand at opera.
And actually, if you have to have an opera premiered somewhere grand, this is the perfect place.
The Santa Fe Opera is a renowned company in a spectacular setting, surrounded by the Sangre de Cristo Mountains of northern New Mexico. Drama in the scenery and sometimes in the skies above.
And you get thunder and lightning,
too. It could be cannon fire.
18 years ago, lightning struck for a then unknown writer named Charles Frazier, who was making his living teaching in colleges. Cold Mountain, his first novel, one he based loosely on Homer's Odyssey, spent 61 weeks on the top of the bestseller list, won a National Book Award, and has sold more than 3 million copies. In 2003 came Cold Mountain the film, and now the opera. And Frazier and his family were there for the premiere.
Did you have any sense of the phenomenon that you were creating when you were writing this book?
Oh, my gosh, no. I mean, the whole time I was working on it, I was thinking, don't ever go sit down at the desk worrying whether it's going to be published or not.
Never mind a movie, an opera.
Exactly.
Millions of people reading.
Right? I think the biggest thing I ever let myself hope for was that I would get a better teaching schedule out of it. So make a move
on the plug your head off. The opera is told through alternating episodes. The perilous journey of Inman, hunted by the Home Guard militia looking for deserters.
Can you really fall? Can you keep us from going hungry?
Ada and her friend Ruby struggle to survive amid war's deprivations. We also see flashbacks to the lovers' early courtship just before the war. Getting from page to stage took several years. Higdon worked with librettist Gene Shear, who distilled the sprawling epic into a theatrical story in which words are now at the service of music.
The job of the librettist is really to structure the story in a way that invites music in. I'm looking for musical possibilities, musical situations, and moments that ask to be sung.
And then to add the words to that.
And then
music.
To add the words to it. The worst thing I think you could do is just take the book and put it on the stage. The idea is not to be faithful to the letter of the source, but to the spirit of the source.
That's perhaps seen most dramatically in the set designed by Robert Brill.
In our beautiful country, we're there.
Veteran theater and opera director Leonard Folia says he wanted an abstract environment, suggesting a shattered world, as opposed to the rich detail of the natural world in the novel.
I can't compete with it. I can't compete with the film. I can't compete with people's imaginations. We've all walked in the woods. We all know what that is. And I knew I couldn't do that. And so I wasn't going to even try. So I was going to just try to get to what I think is the soul of the book and the soul of the story. The main character in this, Inman, is he's been gutted, is one of the phrases that Charles uses in the book, and we use it in the opera. And I wanted an environment that's been gutted.
Director Foley assembled an all-star cast, including baritone Nathan Gunn as Inman, mezzo-soprano Isabel Leonard as Ada, and J. Hunter Morris as Teague, the evil and murderous leader of the Home Guard.
You kind of enjoy playing the role.
It's great fun. I mean, I like to put on the outfit and strap on a gun or, you know, a peg leg or a big flowing wig
and
or something.
Open your voice, your mouth.
And tell a story, yeah.
Like Jennifer Higdon, Morris grew up without classical music in his life. He discovered opera in his 20s. The Texas native has an advantage here.
The swing of the Southern accent is constantly in my ear. I'm so happy to not have to work too strenuously on the dialect. You know, when I, if I take on a role that's Russian or Czech or, you know, even German, it's, I spend many, many hours and weeks and months toiling, trying to get the flavors.
To sound
of
like
the,
a Russian or an Italian or something.
Yeah.
But here, this sounds familiar to you.
It's pretty. It's a lot easier than singing in Czech. I'll tell you that. Yeah.
An hour before opening night, we join Morris in, yes, the bathroom.
Do you always do this in the bathroom?
It's my favorite spot. It's where the best acoustics are.
Nearby, Isabel Leonard was being transformed into Ada. And on stage, some last-minute fight scenes were rehearsed.
One more.
Outside in the parking lot, some Cold Mountain-appropriate banjo playing as patrons took part in the Santa Fe version of tailgating.
Hello. Hello.
Then it was on with the show. The day before, I'd asked composer Jennifer Higdon about the prospects for her opera.
It's hard to get a new opera launched and then into the canon or get it, you know, get it performed again.
Right.
Are you
apprehensive?
In fact, spoiler alert for those who don't know the story, unlike Inman, Cold Mountain the opera has a good chance to survive and thrive. Opera houses in Philadelphia, Minnesota, and North Carolina have already agreed to present Cold Mountain. And on opening night here, composer, artistic team, novelist, and cast took their bows to a standing ovation. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in Santa Fe, New Mexico.
The Santa Fe Opera has announced another upcoming ambitious project. The company has commissioned an opera about the co-founder of Apple, Steve Jobs. The work will look at how Jobs faced his own mortality and explore the events and people that shaped and inspired him. It's set to premiere during the 2017 season.